Platyhelminthes, they have bilateral symmetry. This means they split into two pieces. Platyhelminthes, they have an open digestive tract and use cephalization, and commonly known as flatworms.
If a simple flatworm really needed food, how would it get it to and through its tube? For the answer, just look on the ventral side. The pharynx there isn't really trying to hide. Furthermore, flatworms are really flat. This is an advantage, please remember that. Digestive enzymes can help food decay, and with the help of that makes it all okay.
They come in many different sizes and shapes, also a variety of color and age. Just remember they have no coelom, but they do have germ layers to keep them very warm.
Platyhelminthes, they have bilateral symmetry. This means they split into two pieces. Platyhelminthes, they have an open digestive tract and encephalization, and commonly known as flatworms. Also known as flatworms.
There are two different types of flatworms. The first one is called a Planarian. They live mostly in aquatic habitats and have specialized organs called ganglions. They move with billions of cilia. The other types are called parasites. Some are called tapeworms and flukes. The difference is they've lost their senses.
Come in many different sizes and shapes, also a variety of color and age. Just remember they have no coelom, but they do have germ layers that keep them very warm.
Platyhelminthes, they have bilateral symmetry. This means they split into two pieces. Platyhelminthes, they have an open digestive tract and encephalization, and commonly known as flatworms. Platyhelminthes. Also known as flatworms.
They reproduce by binary fission. It's a process called regeneration. Sometimes they need a host to reproduce. Parasites definitely have to have one too.
Platyhelminthes, they have bilateral symmetry. This means they split into two pieces. Platyhelminthes, they have an open digestive tract and encephalization, and commonly known as flatworms.
Oh, 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 oh,